2020 has shown us is that even the most staid healthcare system can accelerate technologically incredibly quickly when faced with severe constraint or severe obstacles. COVID and the pandemic has been the ultimate constraint on a system that has never really been forced to change in any wholesale way. You had organizations that went from doing, you know, nominal pilots of telemedicine to in a week, 10,000 or more visits of their entire book of business by video and phone. We are an industry that can change. I think we, in some ways, underestimate the economic levers that keep us in the past. And, you know, I give the federal government some credit here at really trying to quickly release some of those mechanisms to make this possible. So, you know, parity in telemedicine, sites of care flexibilities. I think those are really important. And it makes you realize a lot of this has to do with how healthcare is paid for. You know, the reason we have such entrenchment of hospitals and doctor's offices is because that's how we pay for healthcare. And that where you see the true innovation is where people are able to practice outside of that payment structure or where there's been flexibility assigned to the payment structure. Numbers show it. Medicare beneficiaries, you know, the patients over 65 have much higher rates of hospitalization for conditions that are especially amenable to home hospitals. So, and it's the ambulatory sensitive conditions. It's things like, you know, heart failure exacerbation, COPD exacerbation, UTI, et cetera. And so opening up that group of patients and the possibility of payment is really, really exciting. And so, again, I think we're figuring out what it means and what the requirements are, but I think there's a lot of excitement out there that we can finally test these models at